السلام عليكم. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. رب أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ أخذنا ميثاقكم لا تسفكون دماءكم ولا تخرجون أنفسكم من دياركم ثم أقررتم وأنتم تشهدون ثم أنتم هؤلاء تقتلون أنفسكم وتخرجون فريقا منكم من ديارهم تظاهرون عليهم بالإثم والعدوان وإن يأتوكم مسارى تفادوهم وهم محرم عليكم إخراجكم أفتؤمنون ببعض الكتاب وتكفرون ببعض فما جزاء من يفعل ذلك منكم إلا خزي في الحياة الدنيا ويوم القيامة يردون إلى أشد العذاب وما الله بغافل عما تعملون. أولئك الذين اشتروا الحياة الدنيا بالآخرة فلا يخفف عنهم العذاب ولا هم ينصرون. In our previous module of Quran learning series we discussed verses 84, 85 and 86 of Surah Al-Baqara. Verse number 84. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ
مِيثَاقَكُمْ لَا تَسْفِكُونَ دِمَاءَكُمْ مِنْ
وَلَا تُخْرِجُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ ثم أقررتم
وأنتم تشهدون.
Many.
And remember when we took your covenant, saying, shed not the blood of your people, yes. Nor turn out your own people from their dwellings. Then this you
approved or you ratified.
And to this you bore witness.
Yes. Next verse number 85. ثُمَّ أَنْتُمْ هَٰؤُلَاءِ تَقْتُلُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ
وَتُخْرِجُونَ
فَرِيقًا مِنْكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ
تَظَاهَرُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ
تظاهرون عليهم بالإثم والعدوان
فإيتكم مسارا تفادوهم وهو محرم عليكم مخراجهم أفتؤمنون ببعض الكتاب وتكفرون ببعض
فما جزاء من يفعل ذلك منكم إلا خزي في الحياة الدنيا
ويوم القيامة
يردون إلى أشد العذاب
وما الله بغافل عما تعملون.
After this, it is you who kill one another
yes.
And drive out a party of You are
from their dwellings. Yes, from their homes. Then
assist their enemies against them in sin and transgression.
Yes.
And if they come to you as captives,
you ransom them.
Then the recompense of what you do so among you is nothing but
then the recompense of those who do so amongst you is nothing but illa khizyun fil hayat ad-dunya. The disgrace
in this life.
Yes.
In this
and on the day of resurrection, فَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ شَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. And on the day of resurrection, they shall be consigned to
the most
most grievous
torment. And Allah is not unaware of
this. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah is not unaware of what you do. Next verse. أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ
اشْتَرَوُا الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا بِالْآخِرَةِ
فَلَا يُخَفَّفُ عَنْهُمُ الْعَذَابُ وَلَا هُمْ
Those who have brought life in the world
bought the life of this world allowed, yes.
at the price of hereafter,
yes.
Their torment shall
not be lightened,
nor
they shall be helped. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ وَلَا يُخَفَّفُ عَنْهُمُ الْعَذَابُ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ. No. Now, verse number 87. سورة البقرة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ بِالرُّسُلِ وَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى بِنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ فَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ اسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. And indeed they gave Musa alayhi salam the book and followed him up with the succession or the train of messengers, and we gave Isa alayhi salam, Isa the son of Maryam, clear signs and supported him with Ruhul Qudus, the Holy Spirit. Is it that whenever there came to you a messenger, a Rasul, with what you yourselves desired not, you grew arrogant and some of you disbelieved and some of you killed the people. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا وَلَقَدْ and indeed إِنَّا آتَيْنَا we gave Musa to Moses, Prophet Musa alayhi salam, you say. Then وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ and after that وَقَفَّيْنَا and we followed him مِنْ بَعْدِهِ after him بِالرُّسُلِ with a succession or with a train of messengers. After Musa alayhi salam, so many messengers came in the children of Israel. Then فَآتَيْنَا عِيسَى بِنَ مَرْيَمَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ فَآتَيْنَا and we gave عِيسَى بِنَ مَرْيَمَ Jesus, Isa alayhi salam, you say alayhi salam. Then Isa, you say alayhi salam, may peace be upon him, upon Jesus alayhi salam. Bina Maryam, the son of Maryam, radiyallahu anha, you say, Maryam, let me hear this name of Maryam, you say, radiyallahu anhu, radiyallahu anha, female, then. Son of Mary, Al-Bayyinat, clear signs. And we gave Jesus, the son of Mary, clear signs. وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ and we supported, we strengthened. Ayyada means to strengthened. بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ, Ruh means spirit, soul. Al-Qudus means holy. Qudus, holy. Baytul Muqaddas, you know, holy. The Holy Mosque of Jerusalem. Ruh al-Qudus means the Holy Spirit, means Jibreel alayhi salam. أفكلما جاءكم رسول بما لا تهوى أنفسكم أفكلما جاءكم رسول. Yes, that whenever there came to you a Rasul or a messenger, whenever there came to you a Rasul or a messenger to you people Israelites, with what? بما لا تهوى أنفسكم. That is, with what you as yourself desire not. With the message which you didn't wish. Whenever there came to you a messenger, whenever there came to you people Israelites, a messenger, a Rasul, with some messages from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which you don't wish, which you don't like, then what do you do? Then what do you do? Istakbartum. Istakbartum. You grew arrogant. You grew arrogant. وَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. فَرِيقًا, then a group amongst you, a party amongst you, كَذَّبْتُمْ, you disbelieved, a group amongst you disbelieved amongst your messengers, amongst your own messengers sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you, then from amongst you, then فَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ, and a group amongst you تقتلون, killed there, killed them, killed the prophets, the messengers. So many Israeli prophets were killed by the Israelite themselves. Okay. What was the cause? They brought some messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which they don't know. The people don't know them. No, in tafsir. ينعتوا تبارك وتعالى بني إسرائيل بالعتو والعناد والمخالفة والاستكبار على الأنبياء وأنهم إنما يتبعون أهواءهم فذكر تعالى أنه آتى موسى الكتاب وهو التوراة فحرفوها وبدلوها وخالفوا أوامرها وأضلوها وأرسل الرسل والنبيين من بعده الذين يحكمون بشريعته كما قال تعالى إن أنزلنا التوراة فيها هدى ونور يحكم بها النبيون الذين أسلموا للذين هادوا والربانيون والأحبار بما استحفظوا من كتاب الله وكانوا عليه شهداء ينعت تبارك وتعالى. So here Allah describes the arrogance of Jews and their killing of their prophets. They're denying their prophets. In Atu Tabaraka Ta'ala, Allah described Bani Israel, of the children of Israel, about what? Bil utuvi wal inadi wal mukhalafat. That is their rebelliousness, their defiance, and their arrogance. Arrogance means kibr, dikar, arrogance, istikbar. Then, alal anbiya'i, towards their prophets, towards their own prophets, they were arrogant, they were rebellious against their own prophets. They acted against their own prophets. Okay, then. وَأَنَّهُمْ إِنَّمَا يَتَّبِعُونَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ, and they were following their own lusts and desires, their own whims and fancies. They were following, not actually, the messages conveyed to them by their prophets from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But instead, they followed their own lusts and desires. So, whenever their prophets or messengers from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conveyed to them some messages which they don't like, they used to deny them. Okay? Used to kill their prophets. Deny them. Act against the will of Allah. Act against the messages. Against their own prophets. فَذَكَرَ تَعَالَى أَنَّهُ آتَى مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ وَهُوَ التَّوْرَاتِ. Then Allah mentions أنه آتى موسى الكتاب. موسى عليه السلام, you don't say. Then, you're not saying عليه السلام. When you hear the names of prophets, you have to say عليه السلام. Then, Allah mentioned that he gave Musa عليه السلام the book that is the Torah وهو التوراة that is Torah فحرفوها وبدلوها وخالفوا أوامرها وأضلوها and then what did they do they changed حرفا means change وبدلوها they distorted وخالفوا أوامرها and they defied or changed or acted against its commandments the commandments of Torah okay you have seen it in earlier verses this they killed amongst themselves okay they killed their own people it was against the rule of Torah then and so many other things وأولها and also they misinterpreted or they changed the meanings changed the meanings of the verses of Torah to suit to their needs to suit to their whims and fancies to suit to their whims or their desires okay അവർക്ക് ഒത്ത പോലെ വ്യാഖ്യാനിച്ചു ആയത്തുകളെ തോറാത്തിലെ ഓക്കെ മനസ്സിലായില്ലേ ദെൻ وأرسل الرسل والنبيين من بعده الذين يحكمون بشريعته and that Allah sent messengers and prophets after Musa عليه السلام who followed his law as Allah stated then so after Musa عليه السلام also Allah sent so many messengers to the children of Israel to follow Allah's law okay to convey the message of the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Allah stated in the in verse surah al-maida verse number 44 the full verse carries inna anzalna tawrata fiha hudan wa nurun yahkumu biha an-nabiyyuna alladhina aslamu lil-ladhina hadu war-rabbaniyyuna wal-ahbaru bima istuhfidhu min kitabillahi wa kanu 'alayhi shuhada وكانوا عليه شهداء فلا تخشوا الناس واخشوني ولا تشتروا بآياتي ثمنا قليلا ومن لم يحكم بما أنزل الله فأولئك هم الكافرون Verily we did send down the Torah therein was guidance and light by which the prophets who submitted themselves to Allah's will judged for the Jews and the rabbis and the priests to judge for the Jews by the Torah after those prophets for to whom was entrusted the protection of Allah's book and they were witnesses thereto therefore fear not men but fear me and sell not my verses for a miserable price and whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed such are the disbelievers then so Inna anzalna tawrata verily we did send out the Torah fiha hudam wa noor therein was guidance and light huda guidance noor light huda
guidance
yahkum biha an-nabiyyuna alladhina aslamu by which the prophets who submitted themselves to Allah's will that is by this Torah the prophets who submitted their will to Allah did what yahkumu bihan nabiyuna yahkumu they judged for whom they give judgment in matters for whom للذين هادوا to the Jews so they give judgments based on the Torah to the Jews okay والربانيون والأحبار and the rabbis and the priests they are rabbis or priests amongst them also judged for the Jews by the Torah after those prophets then بما استحفظوا من كتاب الله and they were entrusted with the protection of Allah's book وَكَانُوا عَلَيْهِ شُهَدَاءُ and there were witnesses thereto that is The protection of the book is with these prophets and the rabbis, the priests. That is, they were supposed to protect the book. The rabbis and prophets, the rabbis and priests after the prophets. Prophets will die after conveying the message. Then after that, the priest or the rabbis, the scholars, have to carry out the work. They are supposed to protect the book by truly interpreting it, by truly conveying its real messages to its followers. Okay, then. فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسَ وَخْشَوْنِ. So, you don't fear men, you don't fear people, but me alone. Who says? Yes, Allah says. Yes, who says? You don't fear people, but fear me alone. Who says? Allah says. Yes. فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسَ وَخْشَوْنِ وَلَا تَشْتَرُوا بِآيَاتِي ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا. You don't purchase with my verses a little place. That is, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ لِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, such are, they are disbelievers. So, Allah has given clear messages at all times. Okay? To all ummats. Then, those ummats who follow the book, the scripture, have to obey the messages of that book. And the scholars, the rabbis, the prophets have to judge by the word of Allah. Judge by what Allah has revealed. So prophets did this correctly. But some of the followers, and some of the scholars of the prophets, some of the scholars amongst them, they did not do. Okay. So whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, such are those people are amongst the disbelievers, kafir. Okay. Then. So here Allah says, وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ الرُّسُلِ قَالَ سُدِّي أَنْ أَبِي مَالِكِ أَتْبَعْنَا. قَفَّيْنَا means أَتْبَعْنَا, followed upon. وقال غيره أردفنا والكل قريب كما قال تعالى ثم أرسلنا رسلنا كثرة. That is, Imam Suddi said that Abu Malik said that قفينا means succeeded. So after Musa alayhi salam, they have succeeded so many messengers. While others said, some people said followed or succeeded, both means are plausible, or both means are somewhat similar. So after Musa alayhi salam also, there came so many messengers. That is, Allah says what? The verse here is, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ. And we gave, suddenly we gave, and indeed we gave Musa alayhi salam, Musa al-kitab, the scripture, the book. وَقَفَّيْنَا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And after that we followed so many messengers. After him, we followed so many messengers. Musa alayhi salam. Just like Allah said, ثُمَّ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا تَتْرَى. Then we send our messengers in succession, one by one. So many messengers came amongst the children of Israel. Okay, that we have seen. That is one of the blessings Allah bestowed upon the children of Israel. But still, they were arrogant. Many of them were arrogant, except a few. Then, حَتَّى خَتَمَ أَنْبِيَاءَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ بِعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ فجاء بمخالفة التوراة في بعض الأحكام ولهذا أعطاه الله من البينات وهي المعجزات. وقال ابن عباس. Then, حتى thereafter Allah sent the last prophet among the children of Israel. So the last and final prophet among the children of Israel was Isa ibn Maryam. Isa, Jesus the son of Mary. Amongst the children of Israel, the last and final messenger, you know who is? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you take the whole world, the whole mankind, the first prophet is Prophet Adam alayhi salam. That is the first man on earth. The first man on earth prophet Adam alayhi salam, and the last and final messenger, the first messenger, the first prophet is Adam, the first man himself. Then the last and final messenger for the whole mankind, for the whole world, is prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the last and final messenger, or the last messenger amongst the children of Israel, was who? Isa ibn Maryam. Isa, Jesus, the son of Mary. فَجَاءَ بِمُخَالَفَةِ التَّوْرَاتِ فِي بَعْضِ الْأَحْكَامِ. And he came, he was sent with some laws that differed with some in the Torah. So, Musa, after Musa alayhi salam comes who? Isa alayhi salam, or that is Jesus. So, Jesus came with some laws which differ in some context to that of Torah. That is, Isa alayhi salam came with one scripture, the book from Allah. Which was that? Isa alayhi salam's book. Yes, allowed. Injil. Say allowed. Okay, then Injil. So, the laws of the Injil, or we call, know it, New Testament. Actually, New Testament is not the original Injil. Still, we call New Testament. So, the laws of the New Testament, some of the laws or some of the rules were differing from that of those of Torah. Okay, the previous scripture. Then, وَلِهَذَا أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَهِيَ الْمُعْجِزَاتِ. And this is why Allah sent Isa alayhi salam with the miracles to support. So Allah sends messengers, prophets, to the people with some miracles, with some mu'jizat. Otherwise, the people may not believe. Again, some miracles will be there to the prophets, to Isa, to Musa alayhi salam. In the case of Musa alayhi salam, we have seen it, that he had one. Stick. That was his miracle. So many other miracles were there. When he struck the sea with that stick, that there came a road, a clear road. They escaped. And the Pharaoh and his followers who followed them, followed the prophet and followers, they were killed also. Okay. Also, when he struck the Hajar, قُلَّ ضُرِبْ بِعَسَاكَ الْحَجَرْ فَمْ فَجَرْتِ مِنْهُ سَنَةَ عَشَرَ. And from there arose what? 12
springs.
When the Musa alayhi salam, Prophet Musa alayhi salam, the messenger of Allah, struck with his stick upon the Hajar, upon the rock. So there, all those were mu'jizat, miracles. So Allah sends messengers with message and with some miracles. Okay. So to support them. It is to make the people believe. Okay. So قال Ibn Abbas rahimahullah says, من إحياء الموتى وخلقه من الطين كهيئة الطير فينفخ فيها فتكون طيرا بإذن الله. فإبراء الأسقام وإخباره بالعيوب والتأييده بروح القدس وهو جبريل عليه السلام ما يدلهم على صدقه فيما جاءهم به فاشتد تكذيبه. So Ibn Abbas rahmatullah alayhi says, what were these miracles of Jesus alayhi salam? Isa alayhi salam. What were these? Min ihya al-mawta. Min ihya al-mawta. That is, this included bringing the dead back to life. The dead were brought back to life. By who? Usually it is done by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. Ihya al-mawta. Muhyi. Allah is Muhyi. Okay. But here it was shown by whom? Jesus alayhi salam. Isa alayhi salam. Asai mu'ajizat. But all times. When? At appointed times. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, prescribed times. That is, as an ayat or mu'jizat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he brought the dead back to life. Who? Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. Prophet Isa عليه السلام. Then the son of Mary. من إحياء الموتى وخلقه من الطين كهيئة الطير فينفخ فيها فيتكون طيرا بإذن الله. Then another miracle, another معجزه of Prophet Jesus عليه السلام. That is forming the shape of هيئة الطير. هيئة means shape or form. طير means طير. Yes, pakshi in English.
Birds.
طير. Then فخلقه and his creation من الطين from the طين. طين means the clay. You know, kaliman. Then so Jesus alayhi salam created out of clay what? Kahayati toiri, form of a bird, form or shape of a bird. Then what did happen? Fayamfukh fiha. Then he nafuth, that is, or blow into. Nafukha means blow into. Fa'idha nufikha fi s-sur. La. Fa'idha nufikha fi s-sur. Sura nagaratil wudna yari mardi. Fa'yamadhan. Then. So, fayamfukh fiha. Then he blows on it, in it, into it. Fatakunu tayran bi idhnillah. Fatakunu tayran. Then it becomes what? A living bird. It was a miracle. Bi idhnillah. With the permission of Allah. With the leave of Allah. With the leave of Allah. So, Jesus alayhi salam was not Allah. Jesus alayhi salam is not God. Or not the son of God. He is not God himself. But Allah has given him so many signs, so many miracles. And out of this, one is this. That is, he brought the dead back to life. And he formed the shape of birds from clay and blowing into them. When he blew into them, after which they became living birds by Allah's leave, by Allah's permission, by Allah's command, by Allah's leave. Bi-idhnillah. وَإِبْرَاءُ الْأَسْقَامِ وَإِبْرَاءُ الْأَسْقَامِ and healing the sick. He healed the sick with the permission of Allah. Okay, who? Prophet? Jesus عليه السلام. Then, وَإِخْبَارُهُ بِالْعُيُوبِ and foretelling the unseen. Foretelling the normal or unseen, usually not seen by the people. Foretelling. It is Jesus alayhi salam used to say what was kept in their palms, what were kept in their hands, without seeing actually it, without actually seeing it. So it is aib to other people. But to Isa alayhi salam, it was not aib. Not always, at appointed times. Okay, then. وَإِخْبَارُهُ بِالْعُيُوبِ That is, and foretell, to foretell means مُنَّ كُوْتِ پْرَوَجِكَ پَرَيْكَ foretelling the unseen, the غَيْب. Usually, لَا يَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ غَيْب is known to Allah alone. But by Allah's permission, by Allah's leave, prophets or awliya can know the غَيْب to some extent, not always, to some extent. Only when and where Allah permits it. Okay, then. وَتَّئِيدِهِ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ and that also Allah aided him with Ruh al-Qudus. Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Jesus alayhi salam was aided or strengthened or empowered, strengthened, supported by Ruh al-Qudus. Ruh al-Qudus. And what is Ruh al-Qudus? There are different opinions. The major opinion, the prominent opinion is this. وَهُوَ Jibril alayhi salam. وَهُوَ Jibril alayhi salam. Ruh al-Qudus means Jibril alayhi salam. That is, that it refers to Jibril. So all of these, مَا يَدُلِّهُمْ عَلَىٰ صُدْقِهِ فِي مَا جَاءَهُمْ بِهِ. So all these miracles or mu'ajizat shown by Isa alayhi salam showed that he is the true messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he can show all these things. Okay. So all these supports, it's that he is, or Prophet Jesus Isa alayhi salam was the true messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then فاشتد تكذيب بني إسرائيل له وحسدهم وعنادهم لمخالفة التوراة البعض. Then, but this, all this was in vain. Though Isa alayhi salam showed so many signs, so many miracles, many of the Israelites were not willing to believe in Jesus. Okay? They, what did they do? Just as they did to Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Then all of these signs testified to the truthfulness of Isa alayhi salam. Then, but and what he was sent with, yet the children of Israel became more defiant and more arrogant and more envious to him. Envious of this Isa alayhi salam, and did not want to differ with even one part of the Torah. That is, so for them there was Torah. Some law was there. Okay. When Isa alayhi salam came with Injil, the new scripture, the laws or rules of Injil differed to some extent to that of those of Torah. Then many of the children of Israel, many Israelites, did not want to change. Okay? Did not want to change. They did not want to differ with even one part of the Torah. As Allah said about Isa alayhi salam. No, about Isa alayhi salam, Allah said, but so that part, inshallah, we will take later. No time. Slowly.